Hi, in this video we will learn how to generate and download barcode with jQuery. So let us see live demo first, and after that we will see how to configure this code into your project, right? So let us see live demo first. Here you can see I already created one live demo for you. So here you need to simply enter your text, like suppose your barcode number is like this, and if you want to generate your barcode then click on generate. So this is how this barcode will generate. And if you want to download this barcode, then you simply click on this download button. It will download in your PC. So here you can see. So this is how this barcode will download in your PC. Now let us see how to configure this code into your project. So my name is DVS and you are watching Shinerweb YouTube channel. Let us see step by step. Here you can see, you need to create one HTML file, right? So here you can see, simply you need to create one HTML file, and inside your HTML file you simply copy this code into your HTML file, right? I already created that file here. So here I created one file like barcode.html. Now step by step let us see. You need to follow this structure of file, right? In step 2 here you can see, in a head tag you need to include some library. So here you can see, inside your head tag I include some JavaScript library and some CSS library. Here you can see I simply include some Bootstrap and some jQuery min.js, which is used for some designing and some JavaScript code related library. So this is a basic library, which is default library which we are using in all our project. But the most important, here you can see JsBarcode all.min.js. This is the most important library which is used to generate your barcode. So don't forget to include this library, right? So you must have to include this library into your project, right? Into your file. Okay, now once you include some library into your file, after that in step 3 you need to design your web page. Here you can see I take one text box and take one but two buttons, one for a generate barcode and second one is to download your barcode. So here you can see I simply designed that text box and two buttons. So here you can see that same code I have copy here. So here you can see I take one input text, right? And here I take two buttons like generate and download. So here you can see that the same designing are there. So for designing purpose here we are include Bootstrap. Here I used Bootstrap, so that's why you getting this designing here, right? Now simply you have to design, and here you can see I declare one ID is equal to input, and here you can see I created two methods. That method will call on click generate a barcode, and second one is download barcode. That will be used in the further code. So once you design that page, it will look like this, right? Now in step 4, we create two functions, like one is generate a barcode, right? One is created for generate a barcode and second one is download barcode. So you must have to declare that function inside your script tag. So you have to copy this code. Now first we have created generate a barcode. Now you have to copy this code. I already copied that code here. So inside that script tag, here you can see I declared my first function like generate a barcode. You have to copy this code. I will also share this code with you. So don't worry for that. Once you can see this, how it will configure, then you can copy my code. I will share that code also with you. So here you can see, first we created one function like function generate a barcode, and inside that function here you can see we take input which we have created here. So here you can see, here we create one text box like input type is equal to text, and here we pass ID is equal to input. That ID we are using here. So by using document.getElementById, which pass that ID name here, and after that we will get that value. So whatever you have a type in this text box, that value we have a take by using this line. So right, and once you take your input, now here you can see the most important, we declare one SVG tag. Inside that SVG tag, we generate our barcode, and inside that SVG tag, you must have to pass this ID, right? So we will generate our barcode inside that SVG tag. Default, it will display none. So at the very first time, it will not display. So here you can see when I refresh that page. So here you can see your barcode will not display at the very first time. So whenever I click on that generate barcode button, at that time we take that text box value, and after that we take that SVG value. And here you can see if you are not entering any value inside that text, it will return one alert like provide the data first, right? If you provide some data, like suppose I enter some data here, so it means go to else, and the most important, this method will call like JsBarcode. If you are not including your JsBarcode all.min.js, then you cannot use this function, right? Once you include your this file, then use this method like JsBarcode. And inside this method, you have to pass your SVG ID. It means where you have declared your SVG. You have declared your SVG tag here, and inside that ID. So you have to pass that SVG ID here. So here you have to pass that SVG ID here. It means your variable. Here you declare your input and your barcode. It means SVG value. So you have to pass these two parameters. One is SVG and second one is your input text value. And after that, once you pass these two parameter, simply it will process your value or process your data, and it will generate your barcode. And after that, that barcode style display is equal to inline. It means it will display your barcode, right? So when I click on this generate, then it will display your barcode, or it will generate your barcode. Now, this is how you can generate your barcode. Now here you can see, once you generate your barcode, if you want to download this barcode into your PC or into your from your website, so how is it possible? So for that, you have to create one more function like download barcode. So here you can see I created that function here. So for download, you have to copy this code here. So I already copied that code here. This is a predefined code, right? So you must have to simply copy that code, but I will explain how it will work. So first, here you can see when I click, it means I pass one event like onClick, and inside that event I pass one function like download barcode. So here you can see when I click on that button, at that time this function will call, and here I declared that function download barcode, right? Now the most important here, where you have a declare your SVG, that ID you must have to pass, right? So here you can see in SVG we declare one ID like barcode, that ID you must have to pass here. This is the logic, or this is you have to download your barcode. So you must have to pass that ID here, and after that, this is a predefined code. I also searched from Google and I copied that code from there. So you have to copy this code into your, and you must have to, if you want to change your file name like barcode.png, then you can change here, right? Right now I created a file name like download.png. So this is how this function will work. Now here you can see, suppose I click on this download button, So here you can see this barcode will download. So let us see. So here you can see this is how your barcode will download into your PC, right? Now here you can see I declare. Now if you want to download this full source code from my website, then you can simply click on this download button. It will go to Google Drive and you can download from there. So that source code I also share with you, so you can simply download this code from my Google Drive. I will share that link in my video description, so you can download this code from my blog also, right? If you have any query or any question, please write it down your comment in comment section. And if you have any idea and if you want to know how to configure or how to make that happen, then please write it down your comment in comment section. I will try to make that video on that your idea. Or I hope this video will be very useful for you. And don't forget to subscribe our channel, because once you subscribe my channel, then you will get more knowledge, or you will get a new idea and all the things, right? So thanks for watching this video.